How to create a radial bar? That's a tricky question. The easiest and least flexible way to code it would be to use an animated sprite with lots of frames. But thankfully for us, there are other ways to go. In this tutorial, we're going to see how we can build a radial lifebar with only a few sprites and line of code in C2. Let's first take a look at the logic behind this lifebar system. I've set up a Photoshop document to show you that. We have four layers containing half of a ring each. The two orange ones correspond to the lifebar fill, and the black ones will rotate to hide the bar. Let me show you how this works. The first mask rotates counterclockwise over the left half of the orange ring. When it has rotated 180 degrees, the second black mask relays the first one. As far as coding the system is concerned, we will simply convert a percentage of remaining life points to the angle of the bar that should be covered. We can now start working in Constructive. You can find a link to download the bar sprites in the description below. In Constructive, we first need to import our orange half. After that, we import the black mask. We have to set the pivot, or origin as C2 calls it, of both objects to the center of the half ring. That is to say, the middle of the image's left edge. Select the origin icon in the image editor and press 4 on your numpad to set the origin. We're then going to clone our black mask object in the properties panel. This will make it easier to code our lifebar. After that, we have to properly place our assets on the layout. We actually have to replicate the draw order I showed you in the Photoshop document. To do so easily, we're going to first activate the grid. In the ribbon, click on the View tab and check the Snap to Grid option. Then, we have to build our radial bar this way. There's our bar's left half at the bottom. On top of it, in the Z order, comes the first black mask. Next, we need the right orange half. And finally, the second mask object will be on top. We have to place all four assets at the same position. Their pivot points need to be superposed for the rotation trick we're going to use to work. Let's add the function object and the slider bar. We can rename the bar to Life Value. By default, the slider bar's value varies between 0 and 100. As we need a percentage in this project, we'll keep it as it is. We are now set up to start programming the bar. In order to update our life bar, we're going to use a function. The advantage of a function is that we can call it whenever we need to in our code. This will make it easier for you to add this radial lifebar to other CAPEX projects. Here, I chose to call the function lifebar.update. I tend to name functions using the system's name, which is lifebar here, followed by what it does. This function updates the lifebar. This naming convention is actually just meant to take advantage of Constructive's auto-completion and to make it clear for myself as well. In a larger project, you would only have to type life when calling a function to filter all of the lifebar related functions, which could be lifebar.create, lifebar.changeSkin, lifebar.scale, etc. Next, we want to create a global variable called life%. It represents our character's life in percentage. On every tick, we want to set this global variable to the slider's value divided by 100. So don't forget that percentages actually represent a value between 0 and 1. For instance, 20% means 20 over 100 or 20 divided by 100. We add a system action, every tick, and set the variable life% to lifevalue.value divided by 100. Right after that, we can call the lifebar.update function. Okay, now we have a life value to work with, it's time to dive into the fun part. We want the first black mask to cover the left half of our orange bar, remember? In practice, this means that we want the lifebar cache object to rotate over the lifebar if, and only if, the lifeperson value is over 50%. So, if lifeperson is above 50 divided by 100 or 0.5, we set the lifebar's cache angle to lifeperson times 360. What if our life value is below 0.5? Let's add an else7 block in our function by pressing X. Then we set the first cache to an angle of 180 and we rotate the lifebar cache to object just like the first one. We are going to set its angle to lifeperson times 360. We're almost there. If we preview the project now, you can see that we're facing some issues. Actually, to wrap up the function, we need to hide and unhide the lifebar cache to object. So, if lifeperson is above 0.5, we hide it. Else, we unhide this second cache object. Last but not least, at the start of the layout, you can hide the lifebar cache to object as well. And we're done. Before we part ways, I want to give you a little tip on creating the base assets. You have to be careful with the height of the half rings. The sprite's height needs to be a multiple of 2 for the origin to fit exactly in the middle of its left edge. Otherwise, you'll get a 1 pixel difference in the Constructive editor between the two halves when using your system, and it's going to create artifacts when rotating the life bar. Game development is all about logic and tricks. Hopefully, this radial life bar illustrates that idea. Also, there is rarely a single good way to code a system for a game. If you liked that video, you can subscribe to my channel and follow me on social networks. Thank you for watching.